On Philippine inflation falls to its lowest since May 2020. It came in at 1.9% last month. That's down from 3.3%, or the 3.3% reading in August, I should say. Now, this brings average inflation to 3.4%. That's well within government's 2-4% target for the year, giving the central bank more room to cut rates. The main drivers of lower inflation for September: slow increases in food, transport, and housing prices. Well, more news on the 2025 polls. Muntinlupa Mayor Rufy Biazon has formalized his bid for re-election. Rafael Busano now joins us with that story. Raf, over to you.
Hi, Samina. That's right. Incumbent Muntinlupa Mayor Rufy Biazon filed his certificate of candidacy for a shot at the second term as local chief executive on Friday. With him was Vice Mayor aspirant Alin Ampaya, Muntinlupa Representative Jimmy Resmita was also seeking re-election, and aspiring councillors for the 1st and 2nd districts of the city. Together, they called their slate One Muntinlupa, whose aim is anchored on three priority agenda, which is continuity, economic recovery, and boosting of health services, as well as innovation programs. Ampaya, however, is a new addition to Biazon's slate after incumbent Vice Mayor Artemio Simundac decided to, quote, go his own way. Now, Biazon says they each other, but he says that he thinks Simundac has his own direction and his own agenda, which is, after all, his right. Now, Biazon says he is hopeful that One Muntinlupa will receive the same amount of trust and confidence from Muntinlupa voters and see a repeat of a clean sweep during the 2022 elections. It remains unclear, according to Biazon, if Simundac will challenge him in the mayoralty. On the fourth day of filing of COCs, Biazon and the One Muntinlupa slate are so far the only ones to file their documents. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Rafael Busano, there joining us on the line. Go over now to Ara Perez. She has an update on the COC filers for congressional seats. Ara, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Former Makati Councilor Vincent Cese files his certificate of candidacy for Makati 2nd District Representative this morning. Mayoral and Vice Mayoral aspirant Senator Nancy Binay and Monsur Del Rosario are also here to express their support.
Hindi siya deserving compared dun sa record ni soon-to-be Congressman Vincent Cese. Yes. Eh, ang layo-layo nung record nila, di ba? Walang bahid ng kaso, di ba? In terms of services, si nakatrabaho ko na siya for a time na nung na-assign siya sa City Hall, nagkatrabaho na kami. So alam ko yung work ethics at kakayahan niya. At malinis ang record nito, hindi katulad nung isa.
However, Binay believes Makati Vice Mayor Monique Lagdameo, who is running for Makati 1st District Representative, is very much qualified and deserving to be elected.
And I have to be honest, si Congresswoman Monique Lagdameo started her political career with my brother. In fact, magkasama sila sa SK ng aking kapatid. So alam ko yung kakayahan and yung kaya niyang gawin. And at the moment, isa yun sa pinag-aaralan natin na kasi parang hindi naman kami dito para mag-away-away at maglaban-laban, di ba? Eh nakikita ko talaga na very much qualified si Vice Mayor Monique Lagdameo. So pinag-aaralan natin na baka hindi ko na siya kailangan palabanan kasi, di ba, ang gusto ko naman yung mahahalal ay deserving of the post for our constituents and Makati. And for me, parang si Vice Mayor Monique is deserving of that post.
Former lawmaker Egay Arisa seeks a comeback as representative of Caloocan 2nd District. Re-electionists Marvin Rilio and Franz Pumaren also filed their COC to represent Quezon City's 4th and 3rd District, respectively. Since October 1, over 30 lawmaker aspirants have filed their COCs here, and more are expected to file over the weekend. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ara Perez there joining us live.